Hello everyone, welcome to Geology Concepts YouTube channel. I am here to discuss with you an important topic of radial shear, which some of the students find difficult to understand, but I will try to make it easier for you and we'll see how these radial shear forms. So these are subsidiary faults which develop in the overall strike slip motion, whether dextral or sinistral, and there can be various directions in which they can form, and they can also form in sequence or chronologically one after another as long as the strike slip motion continues. So the most prominent ones are radial and conjugate radial shears, which are the first ones to develop, and they are a very good indicator in a field that can actually suggest that strike slip motion must have happened here. So we will first try to understand how these radial shear forms based on the concept of shearing, in which we all are aware of that a simple sphere on application of simple shear converts into an ellipsoid, and we will try to apply that concept to the rock and we'll see that how these fractures might develop. So we all are aware of this fact that a sphere converts into an ellipse or ellipsoid on application of simple shear. So we will try to assume a rock in overall dextral shear sense, so that I can actually resolve two components of this shear, mutually perpendicular two components, one of which will be acting compressionally on this sphere and the other one will act as extension. So as a result, this will actually convert to an ellipsoid because it is extended in the one direction and mutually perpendicular to that it is compressed. So this is, I hope everyone is clear about that, a sphere converts to an ellipse or ellipsoid after application of shear. Now that we have resolved these mutually perpendicular two stresses, I can assign this as sigma 1 and this as sigma 3. Why? Because the compression, which is the maximum one in geology, is the sigma 1, and sigma 3 is tensional, which is considered negative in geology convention. These conjugate radial shears are actually developing at about 30 degrees to sigma 1, which must be or should be developed at 45 degrees theoretically, but considering the cohesion and friction of the rock, they develop at roughly about 30 degrees to sigma 1 on both the sides, and hence they are called as conjugate radial shears. So if this is our sigma 1, there must have been development of conjugate fractures here as well. So yes, there is a development of conjugate pair of radial shears or shears, which we later call as radial and conjugate radial shears. Now this was a very simple idea behind the formation of radial and radial shears, which people, I don't know why, find difficult to understand. So this is how they develop. Now let us talk about at what angle to the main fault. This is the main fault or the main strike slip motion. So what is the relation between these R to this main fault and R prime to the main fault? So as we have actually derived the mutually perpendicular components of this main shear, so they must be at 45 degrees, this sigma 1 must be at 45 degrees to the main fault, and as I have mentioned this, that these conjugate fractures develop at about 30 degrees to this main fault, sorry, to this sigma 1, and this sigma 1 is itself at 45 degrees to the main fault. I can say this R is actually at 45 minus 30, that is about 15 degrees to the main fault, and similarly this, as it is on the clockwise direction, it must be at 45 plus 30, that is about 75 degrees to the main fault. Now those who have an idea about radial shears should know that this radial shear is actually a low angle fault to the main fault, which generally is 10 to 20 degrees, which can vary, and this radial prime or conjugate radial shear is a high angle fault to the main fault at about 70 to 80 degrees. So now I hope you understand how did this 75 or 70 to 80 range come and how does this riddle shear is a low angle fault. Now in all you can see here that there are not just these conjugate shears, of course they are the most prominent ones, but as there is extensional and compressional regime, you might find thrust faults and normal faults or veins and tension gashes all developing in this region. So as I've mentioned that these riddle shears do not develop in only two directions, there can be multiple simultaneous development of fractures as in the case of P, and their conjugates can also be there as P prime. So there are various such faults, minor faults that develop along with the riddle shears, which different scientists name differently, but yes, these R and R prime are the prominent ones. And another important thing about riddle shear is that they always develop in an echelon pattern which is almost parallel or sub parallel to each other, because as long as this shear continues they will tend to develop, and they form this an echelon pattern or overstepping pattern throughout the vicinity. Now if I talk about the shear sense or dipping direction of riddle and conjugate riddle, I would say these riddle shear is actually a synthetic fault, and this R prime is actually an antithetic fault. What do you mean by synthetic and antithetic? Is synthetic faults are those minor faults or secondary faults which are actually dipping towards the direction of main fault, while in antithetic the faults are dipping in the opposite direction to that of the primary or main fault. Now I know this is quite difficult to analyze in this case because the main fault is actually not dipping, but if I slightly dip this main fault in this direction, consecutively my riddle shear and riddle prime will also be rotated about the same angle. Now you can understand this, that if this main fault is dipping towards east, the riddle shear is also dipping towards east, while the riddle prime is actually dipping towards the opposite direction. So this is how they can be called as synthetic and antithetic faults, which is an important property of riddle shears. So I hope I made things clear to you. You have a basic idea now about the riddle shears, and I hope you won't be wrong in the examination if any question comes from the riddle shear. If I missed out anything, you can just let me know in the comment box so that I can correct that. And if you want me to discuss anything particular related to this, just let me know. In the last, I would like you to know about our GATE and NET online classes, which has already started, and a new batch is also going to start soon. So I suggest you to fill this form in the description so that I can contact you and let you join the demo classes. You can also contact us directly on the number given and register for our GATE and NET, also IIT JAM live classes. Thank you so much. If you like the video, share it with your friends, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to comment the suggestions, queries, anything that you like to convey to us. All right. Thank you. Have a nice day.